want to do math on two pieces of frequency domain or order domain data? Well, you can use the data calculator. Here, I want to subtract the difference between sixth and fourth order. So I'll go ahead and select that data from my data set, sixth and fourth order here, and I'll say replace in input basket. And then I'll hit data calculator. Third button in says add from input basket. And now I have the two pieces of data, each with a unique ID, F2 and F1. And I can write a formula down below here, F2 minus F1, for example. And I can name the output of this, you know, difference or whatever I'd like to call it. Hit calculate, and I got an F3. Notice that was this ID here. It was the target ID. Then I can open the display, grab this data. The cursor turns into a four-way arrow. Drop the data in here. And I can see I have the blue curve, which is the difference of the red and green curve. And by the way, if you want to kind of highlight the difference and things like that, there is always hatching, which you can do between the first two curves in any display. Let's try some other math here. So here in section one, I have some FRF data. Now, before I do this math, maybe I'd want to save results that I just calculated. I can say save results as, and this little up arrow here, I can look in any folder in the project and I can say okay, and it'll store the results. So now I have sixth order difference in this TP1 folder. And now what I'll do is I'll wipe out these formulas and we'll try maybe some other math with these FRFs. So let's say I want to subtract these two. I'm going to say replace in input basket again. Grab those two. Maybe rather than do this math with math symbols, I can hit the FX button. And there's actually a bunch of functions in here that you can use on the data. Things like calculating a histogram, integration, differentiation, etc. And I'm going to just pick subtract here. And when I do that, I'm going to subtract F2 from F1, hit OK. I'll calculate the difference, open a new display, grab these three, drag them over, maybe zoom in a little bit. And here I see something kind of strange. The difference is actually bigger than both of these curves, which makes no sense unless we happen to realize, and we can see this with a Bode plot, that this data contains phase. And when we do the subtraction, if we have frequency functions with phase, it takes that into account, whether it's addition, subtraction, etc. There was another version of the formula subtract here, which was actually subtract blocks amplitude, which will only take the difference in amplitude. And I want to subtract two of them, so I'm going to hit this new function button so that I can increase the number of things in my formula. I'll say F2, F1, and then type here, I can look, is with phase, but if I don't want phase, I can say type equal to 2, hit OK. And I can also call this the difference. Maybe I'll call it difference number 2. And if I don't want to perform one of these calculations again, I can highlight a row and hit calculate selected. And it'll only do this calculation. And now I can grab F4 and I can see something that makes a lot more sense. Our difference is now in between our beginning curves, or less, but not higher. So now the amplitudes were actually used in the subtraction, and the phase was ignored. Lots of other functions, you know, addition, subtraction, sepstrums, differentiations, octaves, reciprocal or inversion of data, sums, weightings, etc. Thanks, and I hope you enjoyed learning about the data calculator. Oh yeah, when you're done, you can go back to data viewing and look at your graphs yet again in the navigator.